Hey, what's up, guys? This is a video I actually planned on making in 2020, but as you all know, Flash has died. But luckily, Ninja Kiwi released the Ninja Kiwi Archive on Steam. But as of this video, the archive is having problems because Flash did die, but we can still play the Bloons Tower Defense games on their website and on Steam, so let's get into the evolution of the Bloons Tower Defense series. Jumping into it with the very first game in the series, of course, we have the original Bloons Tower Defense. This classic can date back to 2007, and as you can tell, this game is very old and bare bones. There's not too much going on, the game is moving very slow, and it's missing a lot of features you might be used to nowadays. As you can see on the right, there's only 5 towers in the entire game, along with no powers, no medals, no difficulties, not even background music. I really mean it when I say the first game in the series is bare bones. I like to view it as a blueprint to what the series became today. You didn't have the luxury of saving your game, having multiple maps even, or being able to fast forward. It's stuff like that you notice when playing these older games. It can be little things like how the map looks and the lack of visual upgrades when you upgrade a tower, to bigger things like only having 2 upgrades per tower. Either way, Bloons Tower Defense 1 is a classic. It just started as a free Flash game, but it really is amazing to see where the series has gone and where it'll go moving forward. Without taking too much longer though, let's move into the next game. But less than a year later, in late 2007, we have Bloons Tower Defense 2. I'd like to think Ninja Kiwi made the sequel to capitalize off the success of the first game, because as you can see, it's not too different, but it's different enough to call it a sequel. Now, we do have 3 different maps with their own difficulty, and now you can earn medals on them. The first and only new tower they added is the Boomerang Thrower, and now you can also get powers like Road Spikes and Glue. But other than all that, and a couple of new balloons like the Lead Balloon, there's not too much different from this game and the first one. It's still pretty basic, but you can see them add and build from the original game, but let's see where it goes with the next game in the series. Now we have a trilogy with this third game. This is Bloons Tower Defense 3. This is when I'd say things start to change a little bit more, but it does feel like the first 3 games have their own style of being in the early stages of the series. Like, they're not making huge changes, but enough to keep building off each game, like now having 8 towers and 3 powers, also having more maps with their own difficulties and more medals. There's not too much new with this game, like there's still no fast forwarding or no background music, but now some towers do get a visual change when you upgrade them, and this game did add the Moab. It feels like each game is building off each other, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It almost feels like they could have stopped the series here if they really wanted to, but I'm so glad they didn't because of this next game. Now here we are with what I think is the first huge change in the series. We have Bloons Tower Defense 4. This game feels like when they started to take things seriously and really turn these games into a franchise. First of all, just look at this game. It looks like we have some type of visual upgrade or at least more attention to detail. But that's just the start. This game finally has a leveling system, and that's a big deal for me because of replayability. But there's also 9 tracks along with 4 challenges and 9 premium maps that you can pay for. That's right, this game is the first Bloons Tower Defense game to be monetized. Along with the free expansion, you're also able to buy these upgrades that are pretty cool. Not to mention all the cool new features like now being able to fast forward through the rounds and finally having some background music. Also, some other big ones like having 15 towers with really cool and creative upgrades. You can finally save your in-game progress. You can get more medals and modes like Sandbox and Apocalypse. Not to mention one really cool feature that is still unique to this game over a decade later, and that is the track editor. This was one of my favorite features in any Bloons game ever, and it's a shame it didn't pick up in the later games, and you're not able to play it nowadays, at least not as of this video. I know I spent some extra time with BTD4, but I really think this is one of the most underrated Bloons Tower Defense games, and the impact it had on the later games. This game felt like the series taking the right turn and living up to its potential. Well, let's see where the series goes from here. Moving into the game that really made this series into a household name, this is Bloons Tower Defense 5. It's crazy how big of a game this was. It came out in 2011, but has been receiving updates for about a decade now. Now, I did say Bloons Tower Defense 4 was a big turning point, and it was. It just feels like the fifth game was Ninja Kiwi's baby with all the care they put into it. Like, this really is a full game. I even put over 100 hours into this one game, but enough with all that background, let's talk about some of this game's new features. Just like before, the leveling system is still here, but there's more ways to level up, like the daily quests, the challenges, the random missions, the 10 special missions, the Odyssey, just many ways to play the game. Oh, and not to mention co-op. You can finally play this game with friends and other people. I think that helped blow this game up even more. It was very accessible through many platform releases, and you can play it with a friend. Along with all that, there's a large number of 21 towers and about 80 to 90 maps. Yeah, this game took replayability to a whole nother level. Also to mention over 10 years of adding maps and content. If that isn't enough motivation for ya, they also added permanent earnable upgrades for the first time, along with more medals like deflation and reverse mode. And just to throw it all out there, you're also able to save the game more properly, the game is a little bit more monetized with in-game buyables, there's cool special agents, and the visuals are better. The visuals for this game actually continue on for the next few games, and you'll see what I mean, but let's wrap up this part for BTD5 and keep things going. Alright, so these next few games are gonna be honorable mentions or the spin-off games to the main series. You'll probably know what I mean mentioning the first of these games, Bloons Tower Defense Battles. This game might have a similar visual and gameplay style to the previous game, but this Bloons Tower Defense game is very different from every other because it has no single player at all and has competitive multiplayer only. You're competing for this in-game currency and rank. I think this game was a good first Bloons Tower Defense game that wasn't a part of the main series. There's a couple more games like this, but it'd be really cool to see a Bloons Tower Defense Battles 2 in the future. Anyway, let's keep it going. Now, with Bloons Monkey City, I want to keep this one short because I haven't played this game in years. But this seems to be in a similar multiplayer battle type of style like the last game, but with more of a fortress building aspect. I just remember this being a really cool addition to the series. So far, both spin-off games using Bloons Tower Defense 5's visual style to show that game's influence on the later games, but let's move into the next one. I think this is the game where I lose most of you, but we have Bloons Adventure Time Tower Defense. Yeah, if you're surprised hearing that title, I don't blame you. I never played this game either, but one day I should. It doesn't look that bad. This looks like the most spin-off game here, being an obvious but impressive collaboration with Cartoon Network. Again, I don't know much about this game, so I don't want to give any wrong information, but with this being the last spin-off game, let's get into the latest game of the series. Here we are. Finally made it to the most current Bloons Tower Defense game as of this video, and that is Bloons Tower Defense 6. Now be aware that this is the one part of the video that can get outdated. Like I said earlier about Bloons Tower Defense 5 receiving updates for about 10 years, yeah, we'll have to give this game some time to grow, but we've already been playing it for a few years now, so let's see what we got so far. To start off, we have a new and improved leveling system that also has a skill tree. I love this feature along with being able to earn XP for your monkeys and heroes. And oh yeah, they also added heroes, which I think is a really good addition to the game. Not to mention for the first time ever, the series having 3D graphics. This makes me want to see a BTD Battles 2 with 3D graphics. But many other features include having your own profile with statistics, community challenges with a browser, these races, which are good for speedrunners or competitive players. There's also over 20 towers and about 17 powers as I'm recording this. I imagine there will be more towers, heroes, and skins after this video. Speaking of skins, you're able to earn monkey money where you can buy skins for your heroes or other in-game items. There's also a trophy store to earn even more in-game items. The in-game currencies and leveling up is fair to me. There's also more medals and modes like Half Cash and Chimps, along with the co-op being much more fun in my opinion. There's lots of motivation and different ways to play the game. It also helps that there's about 50 maps in the game and still counting. But that's the thing with BTD 6, it's still getting updates as I'm recording this, and it will for many more years. Even with this game how it is now, it's still very impressive and a huge milestone in the series. This game has had big and recent success, having a peak of over 40,000 players in January, and I imagine that number might grow sometimes. Overall, Bloons Tower Defense 6 shows a lot of potential that has already been met and still has more to accomplish in the following years. Personally, I think this is the most fun and fully made game in the series so far. It's like ever since Bloons Tower Defense 4, they really got things together and made this the best Tower Defense series ever, at least in my opinion. And I wouldn't expect any less from Bloons Tower Defense 7, if we ever get it. Anyway, there you guys finally have it, my video on the evolution of the Bloons Tower Defense series so far. This reminds me of my video from a long time ago about Minecraft, but more recently you should check out my evolution for the SAS series. There are other videos like this one, but I wanted to make this in this specific format of telling you about each game and how they progressed over time. I thought it was fun to look back at the series this way. But yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. please leave a like if you did, because this is one of my longer videos and it took a while to edit and research. Drop a comment telling me your favorite Balloons Tower Defense game. I think my favorite will be whatever the current one is, because they keep getting better and better, but I think things really changed with BTD4. And don't forget to check out my SAS Zombie Assault Evolution video, another game made by Ninja Kiwi. And thank you guys for watching this entire long video, and I'll see you guys later. Peace.